In this lecture, we are going to see the typical objectives of testing. With this, we are going to address the first objective of this syllabus. Just remember, you need to know the objective as it is, as question will come directly from this topic since it is marked as K1. So the first objective is to evaluate work products such as requirement, user stories, design and code. What is the meaning of work product? Work product means output. These are the different stages of the software development lifecycle. So when we are in the requirement stage, the output is requirement. Same way, when we are in the design stage, the output is design document. And finally, when we are in the implementation stage, the output is code. So we have to evaluate all these output. Let's see an example to understand this. Suppose you are in the requirement phase. So you get the customer requirement. And the customer requirement is, for web page, when the login detail is given, the next page shall load in few milliseconds. And if login details are not correct, then show a pop-up. And the first objective states, we need to evaluate this work product. But if we look carefully, this requirement is not complete. There are some open questions like how much time we have to wait, which page will load next, and what is the pop-up content. So these are some of the open questions for which we need clarification. So this is why it is necessary to evaluate work product such as requirement, user stories, design and code. Now, the second objective states to verify whether all specified requirements have been fulfilled. Let's try to understand this. We already know this requirement. Now, we need to see if these requirements are fulfilled in the engineering requirement. After analyzing the customer requirement and asking questions, we finally have the engineering requirement, which includes the following points. Login is correct, go to the next page. Next page shall load in 500 milliseconds. Next page shall contain the personal information. If the login detail is not correct, pop-up shall appear. And the pop-up message is password or user ID is incorrect. So now you can see by asking question, we got all the missing information which we included in the engineering requirement. So like this, in each stage, we have to verify whether all specified requirements have been fulfilled or not. Third objective is to validate whether the test object is complete and works as the user and other stakeholders expect. Test object means object under test. And it is defined as the component or system to be tested. So when you are in the requirement stage, requirement is your test object. When you are in design stage, design is your test object. And at the implementation stage, code is your test object. Now, let's continue with our example. As per the third objective, we need to provide input to the test object and check the output if it fulfills the stakeholder's requirement. Since here we are executing the code, this comes under validation. So third objective is to validate whether the test object is complete and works as the user and other stakeholders expect. The fourth objective is to build confidence in the level of quality of the test object. As we said, in the requirement stage, requirement is our test object. And if we clarify all our requirements in the requirement stage itself, then we can build confidence in our requirement and finally in our product. Now let's discuss objective 5 and 6 together. Objective 5 is to prevent defects. And objective 6 is to find failures and defects. Let's understand this objective. If you find defect in the requirement stage, you prevent this defect to go to the next stage. Now, objective 6 into comes into picture. We need to find the defect or failure in the same stage in which they are tested. Otherwise, defect will travel to the next stage and it will be more costly to fix. And this is the reason this is one of the important objectives of testing, to prevent defect and to find failure and defects. The seventh objective is to provide sufficient information to stakeholder to allow them to make informed decision, especially regarding the level of quality of the test object. So when we find defect, it's not necessary that we will fix all of it before release. But what we can do is to provide sufficient information to the stakeholder so that they can take decision based on the defect and risk associated with it. The eighth objective is to reduce the level of risk of inadequate software quality. Example, previously undetected failure occurring in operation. So this objective is related to the fifth and sixth objective. Here, we need to find the defect in the same stage in which they are introduced. Otherwise, it will be found in the operation. And we already know what is the impact of faulty software. The ninth objective is to comply with contractual, legal, or regulatory requirement or standards to verify the test object's compliance with such requirement or standard. Sometimes you need to fulfill the legal requirements. For an example, if you are working for automotive industry, then you need to fulfill ISO 26262 standard for safety critical requirements. Same goes with the contractual requirement. If you have made any contract with the customer, then during testing you have to see whether you have fulfilled those requirements or not. And that is why this objective comes into picture. To comply with contractual, legal, or regulatory requirements or standards to verify test object's compliance with such requirement or standards. Till now, we discussed general testing objectives, whereas the objectives are context dependent. To understand this, let's have a look into two different testing levels, component level and acceptance level. When you perform testing at component level, your objective is to find as many defects as possible so that they are not found during operational use. Whereas if you are in the acceptance level, your objective is to check if system works as per the customer's requirement. So that is all you need to check here. Before we end this lecture, let's have a look into the important points. So you need to remember all the points the way it is written here. First objective is to evaluate work products such as requirement, user story, design, and code. Second objective is to verify whether all specific requirements have been fulfilled. Third objective is to validate whether the test object is complete and works as the user and other stakeholders expect. Fourth objective is to build confidence in the level of quality of the test object. Fifth objective is to prevent defects. Sixth objective is to find failures and defects. Seventh objective is to provide sufficient information to stakeholders to allow them to make informed decision, especially regarding the level of quality of the test object. Eighth objective is to reduce the level of risk of inadequate software quality. Example, previously undetected failures occurring in operation. Ninth objective is to comply with contractual, legal, or regulatory requirements or standards to verify the test object's compliance with such requirement or standard. And at the end, we need to know objective of testing is context dependent. Thank you.